Keep silent, you are elementary school students today, the teacher said. Raise your hand if you want to speak. Now I will ask a question. What would you do if you saw a ball falling into a deep hole? Then the students expressed their thoughts in turn, but all of those ideas were rejected by the teacher. Finally, there was a student answering correctly. Just pour water into the hole, the ball will slowly rise. Excellent, sit down, said the teacher. However, Papilla's thinking was different. He said he would ask his father to buy a new ball for him, because it would be very dangerous for children to take the ball by themselves if the hole was deep. But the teacher thought that he was annoying and affecting the other students' learning. I didn't mean to disturb. Did I say anything wrong? Papilla said. The teacher was annoyed and said, so what do you mean I was wrong? You think the teacher isn't right, only you are right. Whoever answers correctly, that person is right, Papilla said. Suddenly a little girl stood up and said, the teacher's knowledge is so rich, so she won't answer incorrectly. She worked so hard, she had to stand teaching us all day. So we should be good kids, must listen to the teacher, don't disobey her. When just saying that, immediately there were two rabbit ears sprouting from the little girl's head. Look at her ears. In an instant, her whole head turned into a rabbit's head. This made the kids extremely scared. However, only the teacher smiled. It turned out that in this school, turning into a rabbit's head was the symbol of good students. Students only needed to obey, and then there was a rabbit's head growing. In order to praising the first student who grew a rabbit's head, the school specially held a commendation ceremony. Their goal was to make all students turn into rabbits. From behind the stage, Papilla and Gogo were extremely scared. Since that day, more and more students had risen rabbit heads in the class. The classmates all surrounded Papilla and Gogo, and said the two of them were monsters. They're weird, they're monsters. However, who is the monster? Certainly everyone can already see. These two boys promised each other that they wouldn't definitely turn into rabbits. So they started causing trouble. As a result, they were kicked out by students with rabbit heads. Their class should have become the first rabbit class of the year. However, Papilla and Gogo still didn't obey to the teacher. This made the teacher very angry. Therefore, at the parent meeting, she severely criticized the boy's father. If Papilla and Gogo didn't turn into rabbits soon, the whole class would drag down the school's achievements. Being criticized by the teacher, the boy's father felt extremely embarrassed. So after returning home, he discussed with his wife to find a way. Finally, they made a decision to be able to turn Papilla into a rabbit. His parents decided to start implementing from the smallest things. First, they feed him carrots every day. After that, they changed his room wall color to red, and even displayed many cute rabbit toys. Every morning, they would give him a glass of carrot juice, in which they added some medicine to make his ears grow. This was the plan of Papilla's parents to turn him into a rabbit, but Papilla refused. I don't want to turn into a rabbit. At night, when Papilla fell asleep, they went into his room to measure the length of his ears. This medicine was really useful. His ears had grown by 5 centimeters. Papilla's parents were very happy about this. Although it was midnight, his father immediately called to tell the teacher about this. But the next day, the teacher looked at Papilla's ears and saw no change. It turned out that Papilla had known about his parents' plan for a long time. He just pretended to drink carrot juice. Then he silently went to the toilet and vomited it out. After that, he also put on fake ears so that he had tricked his parents. This made the teacher very angry. So she went to Papilla's house and continued to criticize his father severely. His father could only say, we really try our best. Look, look at the fridge. There are only carrots in the fridge. Then look at the wall. I even turned the wall in the room into red. The teacher said, all these things were unnecessary. The important thing is that we have to change Papilla's mind. After that, the teacher called Papilla and Gogo up to criticize. She talked continuously all day, but they didn't care about it. This made her extremely angry to cry. Listening to the teacher, Gogo just felt extremely sleepy. But a while later, Gogo also turned into a rabbit. In class, only Papilla hasn't turned into a rabbit. He could only play alone outside. Suddenly, there was a little girl in a wheelchair calling him. Surprisingly, this girl was the teacher's daughter. The little girl said, in the future, I must also turn into a rabbit. Hearing that, Papilla was a little confused. My mother must have been thinking too much about you. So while sleeping, she also dreamed that you quickly turned into a rabbit. My mother told me a lot of stories. How can she make you turn into a rabbit? Actually, my mother rarely tells me stories, because her job is very busy and has little free time. Looking at her feet, Papilla felt very uneasy. I'm sorry, I promise you, I won't let your mother worry anymore. Then your mother will have free time to tell you stories. On the way back home, suddenly he saw a person wearing a panda costume and driving a unicycle. He stared intently. The next day, Papilla stood in front of the mirror and put a rabbit hat on his head. His parents saw that their son had turned into a rabbit, so they were overjoyed. The teacher was also very surprised. Then the whole class applauded Papilla. Therefore, they had officially become rabbit class. However, Papilla had turned into a boy who was no longer as open-minded and energetic as before. Since he put the rabbit hat on his head, He also knew what the falsehood was. The man took off his panda hat and comforted Papillo. No problem, it's okay. This is just a fairy tale. Then Papillo suddenly woke up. Everything around came back as before, but in the corner of his room, the rabbit hat was still lying there. For children, this is truly a fairy tale, but as for adults, this is reality. Many people still think that young children don't think a lot. They don't understand anything and just need to obey to the adults. However, let's try to change our perspective. In fact, children also have thoughts. They also have their own opinions and ways of thinking. If they do something wrong, we should patiently instruct them. Don't rebut their opinion outright. We should give children the opportunity to think independently. That is the real purpose of education. Students need to comply school rules and respect teachers. However, we shouldn't make them become passive obedient people. Don't turn them into people who don't have opinions.